go over everything that I need to get this TorqStorm Supercharger to work, from my intercooler, the piping, my fuel delivery. Also got new spark plugs too. So here we go. I'm gonna start cracking these boxes open. Here's the fuel injectors I went with. Fuel injector clinic, 650cc fuel injectors. See if I can get a part number for you guys. So yeah, these are the ones that my tuner, which is Jay Green, he recommended these. So that's the fuel injectors. In addition to my fuel delivery, the fuel injectors, I got a Ken Bell booster pump, Kenny Bell, however you say it. It's a 17.5 volt booster pump. I'm not going to be upgrading my fuel pump. I'm going to give this a shot and see how it goes. But yeah, that's the Kenny Bell booster pump. Next up is the CX Racing intercooler, the one that I went with, a universal fit. Seen a couple people run this intercooler with no problems, so I'm hoping to have good results as well. Came with some brackets for mounting, a little bit of hardware. So that's the intercooler I'll be running. For my spark plugs, I'm running NGK. Here is the part number. You need a cooler plug and a smaller gap when you run a supercharger or a turbo. So here we go. That's the part number on that. Obviously 16 plugs. These are the ones I'll be using. Here is my 3-bar MAP sensor. As you guys know, I'm running the 6.1 intake manifold. And I'm a little iffy on this one. It looks kind of different. It has one mounting bolt. When the 6.1 MAP sensor has two. So everything else about this is the same, but I just wanted to note that. I'm hoping this works. This is the universal coolant reservoir that I got off of Amazon. I've seen a couple people like Frostbite Ram. He runs this with no issues. Also another person that I follow, Hemi Hardit, is also running this. So it has the indicator for the coolant. The stock coolant reservoir has to go when you do this, and I was not gonna pay $300 for the TorqStorm coolant reservoir. I'm trying to get this out of there with one hand without dropping it. So y'all bear with me. So that's what we got. So this is the boost gauge I'm gonna be running. I got it off of Amazon, there's the part number. Nothing but good reviews on this one. I got the one that goes up to 15 PSI just because I don't plan on running much boost. Maybe only 6 pounds of boost at most. My air fuel ratio gauge. I went with glow shifts. It was very affordable. Came with the O2 sensor. All the connectors. So that's what that looks like. This is going to come in handy with getting my tuning down. It's just for a supercharger. You got to make sure that you're running right. But yeah, that's everything that you need. One of the main reasons I went with TorqStorm was just because of the price. I initially was going to go with ProCharger, seeing the price on that TorqStorm, and it was a no-brainer for me. American made, lifetime warranty. I'm going to get everything hooked up, guys, and I'll try to document it as best as I can. Like I said, I'm not a mechanic, but stick with me if you got questions. I'll make sure I respond. My IG is also Can You Hear Me Now. You can hit me up on there if you got questions. And yeah, we're going to get the ball rolling on this supercharger build. I plan on taking no more than a week to get everything hooked up. So, excuse that, my son's upstairs going crazy, 8 months old. But yeah, y'all stick with me, and I'll make sure that I keep dropping that content. I'm going to try to be more consistent, and I appreciate y'all. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. I'm out.